Today, I am going to show you how to make a statement necklace out of jewelry in your own jewelry box. So stay tuned, because you're definitely going to want to see this.
As we proceed to give you what you need.
Here are a few of the things that I used to make this necklace. Now, I didn't use everything shown, so make sure you visit the description box below this video so you can see what I used. Alright, I'm going to start off with my base necklace. This is the necklace that's going to hold all of your weight, so you want it to be a sturdy necklace. Next, I'm taking a piece of paper and I'm kind of giving myself a blueprint of where the necklace falls, and then I'm going to also gauge where I want the necklace to end up when I'm done creating it. So I am just going to draw out the shape I want my necklace to be and go from there. I'm going to simply cut that out, and then I'm going to use that as my gauge to know how far down to go on my felt. I'm simply going to place the necklace on the felt, counting both sides, making sure it's as even as possible, and I'm going to adhere it down. I'm using a white glue. It was a big mistake. I did not mean to buy in white, so make sure you guys pay attention to that, because I did not, and I just was rushing and I bought the wrong thing. All right, here comes the really, really fun part about creating your own statement necklace. It's the layout. This part is where you can be as creative as you want. I got these beads from your local Michael's craft store, anything like that, and basically I'm going to be keeping them on the strings that they came with, and I'm just going to glue them down. Cut them down to size and glue them exactly where they need to be. Some things that were really helpful for me when I was creating my statement necklace was I worked in sections. So right now I'm working in the middle section, and I don't go any further until I get that one all figured out, and then I glue it down. Then I move on to the next section. Since I made the horrible mistake of purchasing my glue in white, I had to be extremely careful when adhering it to the felt. Now, if you buy clear glue, you don't have to be as careful, but it all works the same. And I was really hoping this would dry clear, and it didn't. So I'm glad that I worked on the safe side. Now, felt is a very porous piece of material, so make sure you have something underneath it so the glue does not leak through. Now, coming to my final section of my necklace, and it's really starting to come together and look nice, but I definitely wanted to put a border on it to make sure that it looked manufactured in, like, really nice, not just something thrown together in your kitchen. So make sure you guys find some sort of chain or beads that can go along the perimeter of the necklace. Anyway, here she is. Isn't she lovely? Yes. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Make sure you guys check out the other two videos that I've already posted for this year's Fall Fashion Week. And make sure you come back tomorrow, because we have some yummy goodness for you. I'm doing a collaboration with two other mommies, and we are having our mini-me's in it with us. So definitely come back in and check that out. All right, see you guys tomorrow. Bye.